Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, we'll learn about plotting non-chronological data in a Blazor charts with the category axis. Look at this column series chart, which displays the gold medals won by different countries in the Olympic Games. From this, we can conclude that the text values can be displayed for each data point in the chart using the category axis. Now, let me show you how to customize the category axis. First, I will open an existing Blazor application, where I have already added a simple Blazor chart in a previous video. If you had liked to watch that video, follow the link provided in the card to learn the basics of adding a Blazor chart. You can also find a reference link in the description below. Now, I will run this example by pressing F5. Here, you can see the default chart output with two axes, X and Y, with no data points displayed. Next, I will show you how to customize the Blazor chart with a category axis. I am planning to display Olympic game data in the column series chart, so let me define a chart series tag inside this chart series collection and set the chart series type as column. Next, I will begin populating the data for the chart. Within this code block, I will create a model class called ChartDataModel with two fields, country and medal count. Then, I need to create a list of chart data of type ChartDataModel and assign an array of objects to it. Next, I assign this chart data to the data source property and map the data source fields country to XName and medal count to the YName property of the series. As I said before, I am going to use categorized country name data in the x-axis, so let me customize the x-axis value as category in order to display the medal counts by country in the chart. So, to customize the axis, first I will define a chart primary x-axis tag and set the value type property as category. Along with this, I will set the chart title as Olympic medals. Here, you can view the column series chart with the categorized x-axis, displaying the appropriate labels as USA, China, and so on. And the main title as Olympic medals. Okay, now let me set the titles for the chart axes to enhance the chart's readability. To set the title for the x-axis, I will define a title property and set its value as country. Then, to add a title for the y-axis, first let me define the chart primary y-axis tag and then set the title with the value medals count. See the chart output with the x-axis title as country and the y-axis title as medals count. Next, let's look into the category axis properties one by one with simple scenarios. In the chart output, based on the index value of the data source, the data items are shown in the chart. So, the index value 0 represents USA, 1 represents Great Britain, and so on. To show the data items from Great Britain to India, we need to set a custom range. To set the custom range, let me add two options, minimum and maximum, within the chart primary x-axis tag. For these options, we can set any of the index values from the data source. So, here I will set the minimum range as 1, and the maximum range as 5. Now, you can view the chart output with the custom range that displays the data items starting from Great Britain to India. Like the minimum and maximum options, a custom interval can also be set for the x-axis. Here, the default interval is usually set to 1 so that the chart displays all the data items from Great Britain to India. Next, let's see another important property, label placement. With it, you can place labels either between the ticks or exactly on the ticks. By default, the labels in the chart axis will be placed between the ticks as shown. If I want to place the axis labels on the ticks, then I will set the label placement property as on ticks within the chart primary x-axis. Viewing the chart output now, you can see the axis labels are displayed exactly on the ticks. Alright, lastly, I am going to show you how to add the indexed category axis to render the data points based on the exact index value of the data source. With the current data source, it is not possible to compare the values based on the index value of the data source. So, let's consider two different datasets to display the column chart with an indexed category axis. First, let me remove the existing data source and its related properties. Then, I will define two different datasets, which compares the growth rate of the countries. Here, I will add one more chart series tag and set its series type as column. Now, I will bind these dataset to its data source properties and map its data source fields, country to the X name, and value to Y name property. Before setting indexed category axis, let me show you the chart output with two different data sources. Here, you can see two column series rendered one after the other. Now, I will enable the indexed category axis by setting the isIndexed property as true to compare the data values based on their index values. Let's view the chart output now with the indexed category axis that shows the data items based on the index values of the data sources. Let's summarize the main points of this video. We have seen how to categorize the x-axis of a Blazor chart by customizing its value type, how to position the labels on the ticks or between the ticks, and finally, how to add the indexed category axis. If you would like to see a working example of the charts in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link in the description where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.